In this video, you will learn how to review a drone inspection with the Mainblades Flight app. This part of the app is divided into three parts: reviewing the inspection, reviewing the gallery, and the inspection results. Each of these parts has its own dedicated sub-page, which are Inspect, Gallery, and Results. These are located on the left side of the screen and can be accessed interchangeably at any time from here. Above this little menu, you can see the aircraft registration number, indicating that you're indeed looking at the correct inspection that you previously selected in the inspection history. Below these three subpages, we can see some additional details about this specific inspection, such as the date and time, as well as the number of photos taken by the drone. So what can we do on this page? Right now, we are on the Inspect page. On this page, we're able to look at the inspection in different ways. One way is a two-dimensional representation of the aircraft, divided into different sections. The sections that were covered by the drone are highlighted in orange. Let me select in this case, for example, the right side of the nose. This brings up the schematic representation of that specific part of the aircraft, the so-called aircraft section diagram. The name of this aircraft part is now shown in the top, in this case section 1112R. R means that we're looking at the right side of the aircraft. If we want to look at other sections, we can do that either by selecting them from the drop-down menu or by swiping to the left and right. Let's go back to the nose section. You notice all these blue dots on the section diagram. Each of these blue dots represents a photo taken by the drone from a specific viewpoint. Let's select this one for example. As we can see, the respective photo now shows in full screen. We can also see that the AI algorithm has detected a damage in this photo, in this case an abrasion. If you want to see more detail, I can zoom in with two fingers to get a good look at that damage. We also have a few other options. I click the photo once, which brings up a menu bar on the top. One option I have here is to review the exact location where this photo was taken. To do that, I click the location button on the top right corner. In this case, I selected the right side of the nose, so it will highlight this area. In order to get back to the previous screen, you simply click on the small white X. Another thing I can do here is to click the blue sidebar icon on the top left to bring up a sidebar. In case the AI algorithm has detected the damage, that damage will show here now. In this case, we see the abrasion from the photo listed here. If I see more damages in the photo that were not catched by the algorithm, I can also manually add them here to the database with a blue plus icon. When I click it, I first have to select the relevant damage type from a drop-down menu. Let's select abrasion for example. This will add a new entry on the sidebar. You notice that it also creates a green box. This green box now needs to be resized and moved over the exact position of that damage. To do that, I press and hold this box and drag it over to the damage. It helps to zoom into the photo to do this accurately. To adjust the size of the box, I press and hold the four corners and drag them accordingly so that the box is positioned neatly over the damage. Once this is done, I need to have the algorithm compute the exact dimension and location. To do that, I hit the compute button, which is located at the bottom of the sidebar. After a few moments, the details such as width, length, and location on the aircraft section diagram are filled in automatically. It is also possible to manually add the depth of the damage. Let's select, for example, 2 mm for demonstration purposes here. Reviewing the inspection this way adds value to the database, allowing the algorithm to become more intelligent over time. One last feature that is important to highlight here is that it is possible to swipe through all the photos. What that means is you can go up and down, left and right through all the photos, which makes it super easy and intuitive to navigate through all the photos and to review the full inspection this way. Okay, let's go back to the Inspect page. To do that, I simply have to click on Sections. Alright, let's check out the second way how to review the inspection. On the top left, you see the button called Inspect. We click on that, which brings us back to the two-dimensional representation of the aircraft that we've seen before. However, in the top right corner, you notice a button called 3D. When we click that button, we get to a page with a 3D model of the aircraft. You notice all these blue dots again. Once again, these dots represent a photo taken by the drone from that specific viewpoint. If we click the photo, we get back to the view that we've seen before, giving us all the same options, such as swiping through the pictures, reviewing the exact location, as well as reviewing the damages and adding damages. Okay, let's go back to the previous screen. And one last thing to note here on this page is that also in this 3D view, we have a drop-down menu at the top that allows us to jump to the specific section diagrams right away. Also here, we can navigate through them by swiping to the left and to the right. Alright, now where we have this clear, let's move on to the second subpage, the gallery page. Like the name suggests, this page shows a full gallery of all pictures that were taken during the inspection. As we can see on the top of the screen, the total number of photos is 339. Next to this, we see a button called Pending Review. Photos that were not yet reviewed by the engineer are showing up in this screen. We have the option here to apply two filters. These can be accessed via the filter button on the top right of the screen. With this filter, we can filter for two things. One is the sections filter, which lets you select from all aircraft sections. These are the same ones that we have just seen in the drop-down menu of the inspect page. The other one is the findings filter, which allows you to filter based on all possible damages found during the drone inspection, such as abrasions, cracks and dents. Let me for example select the damage type scratch. As you can see, it is now showing me only one photo, because there is only this one photo from this inspection that contains a scratch. When clicking the photo, we get the familiar page that we have seen before. Alright, let me go back. The third and last subpage of the inspection page is results. As the name suggests, on this page all results, so all damages recognized by the drone, are summarized. You can see this as the final inspection report. On top, we see the currently reviewed aircraft section diagram. In this case, the right side of the nose. Once again, from the drop-down menu we can choose different sections, but we can also swipe to left and right to navigate through all diagrams. So let's have a look again at the nose part. We can now see that a total of 22 pictures have been taken of this part of the aircraft. Across these 22 pictures, a total of 10 damages have been detected, including two different damage types. These are highlighted with red small squares overlaid on the section diagram. When I click on one of these red squares, you notice that the screen shifts downwards, and here we have a full list of all detected damages, highlighting with a small blinking animation the one that I just clicked on. Here we can find a few detailed information about this damage, such as a reference number, the photo ID, the type of damage, its dimensions in millimeter, its location on the aircraft in the stations and stringers format, as well as its status. It's important to note that the photos labeled with the word pending still require a review by the engineer. If I select one of the photos, we get forwarded to the screen that we have seen a few times now, giving us all the same options. Alright, and there you have it. We have went through all steps required to perform a damage review of a drone inspection with the Mainblades Flight app. The result is an immediate digital dent and buckle report for the engineer that can be shared with the aircraft maintenance team to take immediate action. If you like to learn how to set up a new drone inspection from scratch, check out our other support videos. For now, I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching.